can take that ship and race? Am I wrong for looking at this colossal machine of destruction and thinking, Felix, you should hijack that?
Time for a drink? All this fresh air is making my nose itch. Fighting me.
fun.
Up, right? Makes you wonder about their labs.
Yeah, boss?
I'll keep it down.
Reminds me of the first ship I crewed on. Captain had to ban borscht and baked beans.
Thank you.
Nobody in this damn town knows how to clean up after themselves. Thank you.
You don't shoot, I won't shoot. Deal?
Keep them hands where I can see them. What are you doing out here? Well, you ain't trying to eat me. Most things hereabouts are. And anyways, I'm bored. Name's Lillian. Lady named Cass hired my crew as gun hands. I got left here to watch for Cleo reinforcements. They all got pinned inside, so I can't say as I mind. Don't mind the asking, but I ain't telling. You want details? Go talk at Miss High and Mighty What's-Her-Name. She's in the labs, pinned down. If a whole team of gun hands can't get through Anticleo security, what makes you think I could alone? I ain't paid near enough to be dumb. I'm sweaty. I got clawed by one of them monsters. I've been in the dirt all day, and I got bugs in places you don't need to know about. I'm on a fucking break. Got a smoke? Thanks, sister. I've had better. Lost some things in a dust-up. But I didn't get eaten like some of our crew. Got that going for me. My damn cigarettes, for one thing. I was near the Raptodon pen when they got loose. Had to set a few to rights. When I got to checking if all my parts were still attached, I realized I'd dropped my cigarette case. I look busy to you. It's surrounded by pissed-off Raptodons. My mama didn't raise no dumbasses.
This was a Spacer's Choice commemorative case. Some promo for Founding Day they did back in, I forget the year. Worth decent bits to collectors.
If she can't hang on to it, maybe it'd be better off in someone else's hands.
An outdoor Raptodon pen yonder, past the main entrance. Law only knows why they're breeding the damn things. I'd be obliged. Just don't lose any parts trying.
Hey, boss. I think we can get in through that vent shaft.
After you. Reminds me of my first cabin on the Groundbreaker. Four roommates, one bathroom.
Okay. Hey! You! Over here!
Oh, good. You're not shooting at me. That's a start. It's been a bit of a day, so I'll get to the point. Yes, I have Crane's research. No, I'm not giving it back. Sorry to disappoint you. I suppose it does not matter. Either Crane sent you, or you are some scavenger come to rob me in my moment of weakness. Let's make a deal. I'd like to go on living. You'd probably like to make some money. Help me get out of here, and I will pay you for your trouble. You mean other than the satisfaction of doing me a good turn? Trust me, I'll make it worth your while. Same reason you are, more than likely. I imagine we picked up the same tip. Secret research facility, abandoned town, minimal security. No, but it is a secret. Well hidden. Off the map. Any place worth hiding is worth raiding. Granted, diet toothpaste is not exactly what comes to mind when I imagine secret research and underground labs. Diet toothpaste. Can you imagine a more pernicious example of corporate materialism? I do not know what is worse, working here or dying here. What matters is that I have been lied to. I was led to believe this was a high-priority corporate facility hiding valuable research. This job was not supposed to end with me stuck in some wretched lab smelling like rats. So I would be very much obliged if you gave me a break. You mean other than the satisfaction of doing me a good turn? Trust me, I'll make it worth your while. The first thing I need is a key card to unlock my door. Then I'd need you to clear me a path out of here. There are two ways out. The quickest is through the front door, but Cleo security's bottled up in there. If you don't want to shoot them, I suppose you could talk to them. The other way out is through the loading bay, but you'd have to clear out the rafts for me.
Then I could just slip out the back, sight unseen. Because Crane is a tool. Because no good deed goes unrewarded. Because doing me a good turn is the honorable and decent thing. Take your pick. Crane is being used by Auntie Cleo. And now he is trying to use you. So what does that make you? Fair. But while I may be trapped for the moment, those scientists are trapped in corporate slavery for the rest of their sad, sorry little lives. Don't you see? I am setting these people free. I am doing them a favor. Won't you do me one in return? I do not want charity. I will put something pretty in your palm for your trouble. You have got my word on that. You might be the first stroke of luck I've had all day. Thank you. I'm in your debt. Ask away. I have got nothing but time. Sell it, of course. I don't have any use for the scribblings of idiotic scientists, but whoever gave me this tip obviously does. Assuming I make it out of this place alive. And with my ship out of commission, I'll have to leave on foot and hope my luck changes. One problem at a time, I suppose. From the day we are born, we are made to obey. Never question, never hope, never dream of anything greater than the lot appointed to us. Corporations expect us to work until the day we die. But they could not give a half-bit shit about our lives. Nothing beyond the purview of a talented freelancer like you. You really expect me to just let them pass? Why? So they can regroup behind their walls and mount another assault? Never mind. I'm obviously in no position to argue with you. If you can talk those guards into standing down, my people will follow suit. I'll help however I can. A Raptodon is an apex predator native to the jungles of Monarch. They are entirely unsuited to life on Terra 2, which may account for their horrible temper and appetite. What? Do not give me that look. I am allowed to have hobbies. Biology happens to be one of them. Yes, we accidentally released the Rapts into the world when we attacked this place. But I am not at fault here. Those scientists had no business experimenting on these creatures. The Rapts took us by surprise, as they would anyone. My crew were split apart and lost in the corridors. They went one way, I went another. You'll need a keycard to unlock my door. I don't know where they're kept, but I'd start by checking the security office. Take your time. I am, to my chagrin, not going anywhere.
Don't know about you, but this just makes me want to get inside even more.
Here they come!
We didn't even get our hands dirty.
We saw everything. You must think me a fool. I was watching on the security cameras. You got downright friendly with the outlaw leader. I reckon we got nothing to say to each other. You best back yourself out of here. Nice and slow. You got 1 minute. Starting now. You convinced her to let us leave in peace. Listing the ills we've been done ain't exactly putting me in a mind to compromise. I gotta believe that all we've done will mean something to the company, to Doc Crane. That effort will make up for mistakes. The only person Doc Crane ever took a shine to was Jameson. Figured he just didn't know how to talk to folks. But here we stand, and he's nowhere about. I reckon I don't see any better solution. Fine, damn it. We'll pull out. Here, my key card. It'll get you access to the whole place. Full stakes, people. We're heading back to town.
Picked the wrong damn day.
It ain't stealing if no one sees. Mind if I grab a few souvenirs?
I would ask what was on your mind, but the answer is obviously me. I've never been so pleased at the sight of an open door. Please tell me you've cleared a way out of here. So you have. I am much obliged. And now, if you do not mind, I have had quite enough of this wretched place. Good. I never trust a freelancer who works for free. Oh, really? And why, pray tell, would I do a thing like that? Your point is well taken. I would rather not spend the rest of my days looking over my shoulder for the shadow of my headhunter. Here, take the damned research. Tell Crane I hope he chokes on it.
Look at that. Those idiots got themselves a Mama Raptodon.
Make him regret it!
Again.
their mistake. Reminds me of medical school. Time for a drink?
Fancy looking smoke box. Stinks like Raptodon, though.
Thank you.
Seriously, don't get yourself killed. It's a nice cigarette case, but it's still just a cigarette case.
You're shitting me.
You ain't so bad. Here's something for the trouble.
Boss called and said to pack it in for pickup. Reckon that's your doing.
Thank you.
lab. What's left there that's worth dying for?
You let them get away. Worthless, the lot of you.
Well, you get what you pay for, don't you? Doc Crane better get over himself.
That no-account fool Porter and his crew are even more worthless than I could have imagined. They've abandoned their posts. This is madness. My research? Please tell me you've recovered it. That's... You can't possibly understand the enormity of what you've done for me. Did you find my colleague, Jameson? Jameson. I didn't do right by him, did I? Only cared about how he helped or hurt my research. You understand nothing. Me, least of all. That's not true. I'm a man of great caring. I'd never own up to that, though it'd be true. It's this place, this colony. You can see that, can't you? I need to get to Byzantium. It's the only place life can have meaning. You're right. And what's worse, I've always known it. But there's nothing to be done. This is the life I've made for myself.
Any news? On that thing we spoke about? You know, that thing? Don't keep me in suspense. Did you get my stuff? I mean, not mine. It's for other parties. Buyers. No kidding? You're the best! This is gonna make me so popular. I mean, with the people who buy it, not by using it. Because I'm not. Take this. You earned it. If you run into me again after all this is over, maybe I'll have more. Pleasure doing business with you.
Captain, Felix and the Vicar are arguing again.
Since when?
Since the Rangers decided their eighth back should stay in the Wednesday zone. Come on, Felix. The Rangers threw that game.
Were we listening to the same game?
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts? Yes, I've been meaning to discuss exactly that. Now that we know where, the Scholar is, when will we be searching him out?
Good to see you, boss. Didn't I tell you? I'm secretly the chairman's orphan child, abandoned at birth in the back bays. Honestly, before you pick me up, I was living in the back bays. Spent my whole life up there, watching ships roll in and take off. I always wondered when my ship would come. I was what folks on the Groundbreaker call a stowaway. Means I was invisible. Life carried on for everybody else, but not for me. I had to make my own way. That's what they called us. Orphans with no family, no company to take us in, nowhere to go but the back bays. The word's a touch kindlier than Rungleech, but the meaning's just as clear. If you can't support your own self, you don't deserve to be on the Groundbreaker. Same way we all do. Look for work and hope somebody would give me a shot. Hauling boxes was about the only work I could find. Hated every second of it. Foreman and I never got on. Could be I was overreacting. A better man might have turned the other cheek. Exercised a little bit of that, what's the word? Restraint? But on the other hand, broadsiding the jackass with a tossball stick? That felt good. That felt real good. You ought to try it. Oh, I can do civilized. Proper civilized, too. Genuflecting and everything. I caught a real lucky break. If you hadn't picked me up, I'd still be back at the docks, waiting for the day my ship arrives. Yeah, I guess my ship did arrive in the end. I've got you to thank for that. Thanks for listening, boss. Let's get going.
As always, I want to occupy... Bokonu, the author, had some interesting theories. Unfortunately, he was also...
Oh, hello. Why do you seem familiar? Have we met? Ah, yes. Very good. And have you done that? What a relief. You hold months of work in your hands. Anton would have just given them to Porter without a second thought. What a waste of potential that would have been. Sadly true. Contraband does tend to fetch a high price among the colony's ne'er-do-wells. So be it. I'll buy them off of you. Much obliged. Here are your bits. Now, let's see here. Attach this, twist that, apply a little pressure, and voila! I can finally call this little side project complete. Thank the law. I can't be caught with this. You take it. If R&D buys the schematics from me, perhaps I'll get you the first model, hot off the presses. I'll call you? Yes, I'll call you.
Thank you.
I believe I hear Felix and Parvati discussing the latest... We've arrived at the Groundbreaker. I think I'll initiate... an unscheduled...
Hey, be careful with those crates, huh?
Mizzle's Purple Berry Crunch.
Have you... You don't hurry up. Someone will get to snooping around there before you do. What's that? Speak up now. What'd you turn up? Well, that's just swell, sweetheart. Good for you. A shame you didn't visit old Gladys first. That would have fetched a good price. I may have thrown in a batch of my famous sugar cookies just to sweeten the deal. If Auntie Cleo's exporting rats from Monarch, golly me, someone's going to be in the soup when they get caught. Bless your slippery little fingers. Isn't that just a shame? Prototype schematics go for a fair handful of bits around here. Darnation. It sounded like a gold mine, but maybe that's just my old hopes getting in the way. I suppose it can't be helped. Law bless you for doing the legwork, sweetie. Don't forget your pal Gladys now. You can come visit anytime. Fantastic. Do be careful with it, dear, as these keys tend to be a tad hard to acquire. You should have a chat with Lilia Hagen in the sublight offices. She's a dear. You'll love her. Now, was there anything else? I've got a lovely little throw pillow. Just something I toss together. Like to keep my hands busy. Gracious. I was just sitting down for tea. Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me. It's almost time for today. Want a charming copper?
Monarch's a moon. I think it counts anyhow.
Monarch is a wretched hive of terrorism and anarchy. We'd best top off our ammo stock before we leave.
Captain, Felix and the Vicar are arguing again. Just to warn you, we may have a bedbug infestation. I am...
Initiating initialization sequences. Greetings, customer! This SAM unit is unable to locate your registered information. Would you like to register your SAM? Registering new owner, Captain. SAM units live to clean and clean to live.
You don't think that's a problem? Whole ship's running on a computer's fancy.
No, Felix. The concept of a ship computer does not make me nervous. Are you scared of Ada?
I ain't scared of Ada.
Good. I'm glad we cleared that up.
She's a computer, Max. What happens when her equation...
Where do you get these items?
We'll be here, Captain. Or will...
Make this conversation worth my time, Captain. Sure is. Welcome aboard, Contractor. One of my guys in Stellar Bay has a lead on some high-grade salvage, but he went dark before he could spill the goods. We arranged a drop at the Saltuna Warehouse's loading dock. Find whatever he left there and take it to Fallbrook. My gal Catherine will be expecting you. When the board pulled out of Monarch, they buried or sealed anything they couldn't carry off-world. Apparently, one of Catherine's teams uncovered an abandoned lab with full tanks of Alta Vitae gas. It's exactly 1 million bits per cubic meter. Before you get too excited, the only thing rarer than Alta Vitae gas is a reliable buyer. Dangerous stuff. Acid for the nucleon in your cells. It's no good to anyone outside of a lab.
Ah, yes, Alta Vitae. I knew someone who inhaled it by accident. I'd never seen anybody spontaneously combust before.
I see your friend here is the brains of the operation. Good. Every salvage crew needs one. A few of my contractors run flights in there and out again, working around the board embargo. We keep the community lubricated with a steady supply of booze and unconventional erotica. Byzantium kids with more money than sense can thank Sublight for their good time. One of my guys filmed a Raptodon grinding on an automech. Didn't end well for anyone, including the cameraman. Now, get going. Catherine will brief you on the details when you check in with her at Fallbrook. One last thing. When you're on the job, keep a pair of eyes in the back of your head. Understood? Don't go looking for anything, except salvage. Just watch out. You'll do fine. Probably nothing to worry about. Probably.
I ain't worried if you aren't, Captain. Honest.
Crew members Ellie and Max are engaged in a heated discussion in the kitchen.
Max. Maximilian. Vicar. Vicky. Something on your mind? I'm a surgeon by training and a pirate by inclination. Not much else to know, Captain. I like long walks on the promenade and the smell of Spacer's Corona. I make a mean zero-G cocktail and I've got a meaner right hook. Sure do. Some of it was even legal. There's a lot of business that goes through the Groundbreaker. Some of it's board-authorized freight hauling, and some of it's not. I've done all types of work with all kinds of crews. If there's one thing you ought to know about me, it's that I won't tell you your business. Your ship, your way. Glad to hear it. It's worked for me this long. Well, my blood type is AB positive. I'm a Leo, and I despise Space Hospital. Never mind what anyone else tries to tell you. That about covers it. Aw, come on. That stuff's boring. Look, the thing I've learned about living in close quarters is that you've got to give people room to breathe. I'm all for making a few bits together and having fun doing it, but let's keep a little professional distance. It's a mix of whatever you've got on hand, usually zero-G brew with some Spectrum vodka if you're lucky, purple berry shake if you're not. out on the edge of the Aether, we learn to make do with what we've got. No room for fancy predilections. No complaints here.
I find myself marveling at the complex something vexing you, Captain?